come right through here.
That's a double, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay,
I got an M27 key I could let you through up here, man.
Okay. Just
special gate for a double stroller. Extra wide load needs a separate gate.
Yep.
Much.
Okay. I think you can get your band.
There's more.
Whoa.
I don't want to get in your video.
One more.
Yeah. What's your favorite so far?
You gonna go down the hill?
Mama.
What?
Everything tastes good, boy? Little pavement there.
Thank you.
Let him take them from your hand.
I don't know.
You do it, Mama.
Can I get this?
That doesn't hurt. Let him take it from your hand. Doesn't hurt. Let him take it from your hand.
What's that car? Let me show mommy my tummy.
Show me what you got in your hand.
Here we are.
Once again.
Okay, now it's... This is what Hershey, Pennsylvania looks like on the outskirts. Actually, this one lane crap is what the entire state of Pennsylvania looks like. It's a pain.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, Dad.
Now, let's go inside the plant and take a look at the fascinating process of manufacturing chocolate. Good chocolate making requires more cocoa butter than is found in the chocolate liquid. So, from some of the chocolate liquid, it is extracted using large presses.
Hi, Corey.
Hi, Mom. Wave.
The unit seen on the left is the central mixer, which receives the three basic ingredients. We are now entering the refining area, which consists of the processes called... On the right is the completely...
Rain is not good for video cameras, so what we're gonna do is put you in the trunk. You have a nice bath.
Sort of a sickness. He made this two-sick roller coaster. director and filmed it. And fortunately, the film was a big hit with all the other twister nuts, which just encouraged him to do more. Something bigger.
Ha ha ha! is the coaster ride. Everybody gets a ride at the end of the tour. Why don't you get on board? Everybody has to take a ride. Bob, we have to change your mind. One of the questions people ask is, so why do we call it termite? Well, some of the wood that was sitting around got chewed up a little bit, but most of the structure's safe, so I don't think you should worry about it. Have a nice ride. I really hope you enjoy it.
Convention of the ACE, the American Coaster Enthusiasts.
We are an organization dedicated to the enjoyment, appreciation, and preservation of the roller coaster. So yeah, this is what we do, is we'll gather 500 of our members at a great amusement park. We'll take over the place and just have a great time.
Indeed, the Hercules is understandably the latest mecca for coaster enthusiasts. After all, it's only 1 month old. It's the largest wooden roller coaster in the world, and as such, it delivers exactly the kinds of sensations the conventioners are looking for.
You're pulling between three and a half G's at the bottom of the first hill. To put that in perspective, the astronauts black out at six.
It's an all-gone feeling right here in the pit of my stomach.
It beats 10 cups of coffee for waking you up in the morning.
We have about 500 of us here from all kinds of countries, by the way. We have someone here from New Zealand.
It's an adrenaline trip. We haven't got them in New Zealand. We've got baby ones, but nothing like this.
This is what we do in our vacation time. I mean, this is all spare time activity for us.
An activity that causes the crew to gather in the early morning before the park opens to the public to enjoy several uninterrupted hours indulging their passion as often as they want.
We go out and we do something that people consider a little wacky, maybe, but in an eccentric, fun way. I think it's a fun hobby to have.
And while the gathering is not sponsored by any commercial organization, nothing seems certain. People who make stomach antacid are missing out on a golden opportunity. And Don Frolic, Channel 6 Action News in Allentown.
All right, Don. Nightline is next on Channel 6. Action News continues tomorrow evening with Rob Jennings and Jerry Papa. And now for Don Tomlinson, Dave Roberts, Jim Gardner, and the entire Action News team, I'm Lisa Thomas-Laurie. Have a good night and a terrific weekend.
We're leaving Allentown. I had to get a picture of this Art Deco factory. There's our car. Boys are all ready to go. I guess. There's Mom. There's the boys. Yeah, he's ready all right. One of the rare times. There's no traffic.
Oh, such a lovely day here on the freeway, the turnpike. Oh, who's passing us on the right? Slow down, Kim. Oh, there's light too.
We found it. Hey, where's everybody going? Where you going? What's going on? Is it our breath or something?
It's the kid.
He's so
fun. He just towers over her.
Say hi.
No, he'll probably go slap her on the head.
Say hi, baby.
I didn't get that.
You didn't? Well, you can get him to say it again if you want. Hey, Corey, say it again.
I meant to.
That's good. You're a star.
Where are those?
You want to play with those? Those are closed.
Next one of those. Oh, because he's holding everything from there. All the shirts. I didn't buy all the hats. What?
Is that?
We went off and we left. What you gonna do?
We crashed
early. Oh, we might
ride.
Uh-oh.
Maybe.
Here we go, Corey. Down the hill.
Here we go.
Whee! You like that? Just hold on. Whee! All right. I love it.
Walk down the ramp and enjoy the day. Come to the Lake Minnetonka Bar.
You did it this way, Corey.
You can ride again?
I don't think so.
You don't like that?
What'd you say, Corey?
I don't like that.
You don't like that. Okay, we won't do that again.
Like it?
No, but they survived it, so. You like Daddy's coaster better? I thought so. Monorails. Do you like monorails?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, okay. I love monorails.
Just so you know where I'm coming from, I have to look at things from my personal point of view and from a professional point of view. From my personal view, I like them. The technology is interesting. It's fascinating. Yeah. I read up on the history and everything else. Yeah. It's lucky it's also my job. Oh. So I have to look at it both ways. So I like them in the same way, which I know you do, as you know, because they're neat and they're interesting and they have a lot of, they do have more potential and all that kind of thing. But for, if you're thinking of putting them in as a major transit system, you have to look at them in a practical sense for the individual area you're talking about. And that's where in the United States, they don't stack up from a technical point of view as well as tried and true modes do. They don't offer any disadvantages. There's disadvantages about the switching. That's a bunch of baloney. But what they do is they don't have any advantages over other modes. And because of the fact that they have, people are unfamiliar with them, they do take up more space. For example, in America, unlike Japan, like you're talking about, things like aesthetics are more important. If you want to put a monorail in downtown, either in a subway or in on an elevator, which you have to do because monorails cannot run at grade like light rail trolleys can. They have to be separated, and anytime you take any technology and separate it from other traffic, you're tripling, quadrupling, 10 times in the expense because of bridges or subways or whatever. What happens with monorails is if you have it running on top of a rail or underneath a rail, you have to have more vertical space than is required for subways or light rail. If you're what that means is if you're going underground, you're quadrupling your construction cost, which is already expensive for any kind of subway.
Corey?